Really looking forward to the film. It's we need a laugh. It's been a long week. It's prop week this week, so we're working with lots of hats. I've got three hats to work with, so it's been a lot of swearing and a lot of kicking hats around. So it's nice to come here and
chill out, relax,
have a laugh, then we can go home and get picked up tomorrow at 8 o'clock in the morning to go train again. So can't wait.
Obviously, the film stars the magnificent Seth Rogen and Barbara Streisand. Are you guys fans of them in particular?
Yeah, massive fan. I'm a massive fan of Seth. I mean, I think he's an absolutely cracking actor. I loved him in the film he did with Adam Sandler. He's done so much. He's a comedy actor, a serious actor. I love actors that are versatile like that can really like switch it on and on when they need to. Bit of a Barbara Streisand fan?
Yeah, no, totally all the way. Yeah?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Pop it.
Drop it.
Clearly in this film, Seth has to put up with the ultimate pushy mum in Barbara Streisand. Is that slightly similar to the relationship you guys have had working on the show?
It is. I wouldn't say I've had to put up with her. I think she's had to put up with me rather than the other way around. I can have my temper tantrums. I'm quite a perfectionist, so I like to like perfect my moves. And if something doesn't right, I want to start it again. And she's got this little face that she does. Like, we do something, and if I land it and she's not smiling, it means I've done it wrong. But she won't tell me, so I have to do it again until she goes, okay, that was it. And she'll have put a big smile on, just like that. And I realise I've done it right. So it is. But she's been absolutely fantastic. She's coached me all the way through, and I'm skating so well because of Ray.
What's been your proudest moment so far this series working with Matt? I mean, when have you felt the most proud of what he's doing?
Every Sunday. I think every Sunday I'm proud of you. You know, he surprises me every Sunday, you know. He's amazing. I enjoy every single second. And I don't want it to end. I really don't. 3 weeks. I can't believe it.
You've got 3 weeks left. It flies by as well. It's one of those things you train for 3 months solid, doing this first routine, and then it just goes as quick as anything, and it's nearly over. 3 weeks left, and then that's it. See you later.
Bye.
For you personally, what's been the biggest challenge and the biggest reward so far of being involved in the show?
The biggest sort of challenge was sort of obviously taking to the ice and learning a totally new skill, but the biggest reward is for the public to see me as for who I am, for Matt Lipinskas, rather than as Anthony Moon from EastEnders. So. And I mean, lots of people have been coming up to me saying, I really like see that you're really like determined and really like, and that's what I am. I'm really, if someone gives me something to do, I'm really determined at it. I want to progress in it. I want to be the best I can be in it. So that's just my attitude with anything I do. So that's been the most rewarding thing.
I mean, you talked about acting there. I mean, have you got anything lined up after the show? I mean, I know you're so busy at the moment.
Yeah, it's busy at the moment. I mean, all the focus is on Dancing on Ice, but there are things. Me and my agent have been talking a lot to a few different people, and there are some things coming up for me, which I'm looking forward to getting back into acting, and some things coming up for both of us, so it should be fun.
I mean, bring it back to the show. I mean, obviously, taking the professional opinion, apart from your lovely partner, is there anyone else this series that you've been especially impressed by?
Pamela Anderson.
Sure, Pamela Anderson. No, I think Gareth. Gareth, he's come quite a long way. And I think because these boys are so close, they've become quite best friends. I want to see him do really well as well, don't
you? Yeah, you do. What me and Gareth say, and Luke and like a few of us say, that we're not in competition with anyone else.
No.
We're only in competition with ourselves. So, I mean, if Gareth was to win it, I'd be so happy because he's such a nice guy. I mean, he's so down to earth. He's always cracking jokes.
And he's your biggest support system. I mean,
yeah.
He's my
biggest fan for some reason. I'm his biggest fan, so it's brilliant. I mean, that's one of the things as well. Not only have I got like, you know, a new friend for life with Brianne, but with Gareth and Luke and people like that, I'm going to be friends with forever.
How important a role do you think the show's had in encouraging people across the nation to get out there on the ice for the first time?
You know, I give them all a lot of credit. It's a new challenge, and for me especially, I'd love to do something like that. I mean, I'd love to do a show with him and him teaching me how to act, and I think they're, you know, they've got balls. Should I say that? Ballsy. You are.
I am ballsy. You're ballsy, though.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Don't have balls.
Sure.
Well, finally, before we let you go, you mentioned it's prop week this week, and you mentioned lots of hats. I mean, can you talk a little bit about that? I mean, obviously, you don't want to give too much away.
Well, hats has been on the show. How many times has it been on the show?
8 years.
8 years. Mm-hmm. It's been every year.
Yeah.
And everyone's dropped it. No one's ever been for it.
Yeah, everyone has dropped.
Everyone drops a hat.
Yeah.
And just one hat. So this year, to challenge me, they've given me three to drop. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I can keep them all up in the air and skate well. It's good. It's a fun routine. It's three different hats, three different types of music, three different characters, three different types of skating. So it's full on. It really is full on. Looking forward to it.
Mhm. Harry, it's wonderful to have you here tonight. You looking forward to the film?
Yeah, I am looking forward to the film, definitely.
Are you a fan of Seth Rogen, Barbara Streisand?
Barbara Streisand, hands down. I'm obsessed.
Why are you so obsessed with her? I mean, it's a big question.
Do you know what I think it is? Since that song came out about her, that Barbara Streisand, that one, yeah, I love that. And I'm obsessed with that song, so.
Keeping yourself busy and out of trouble, though. So what have you got on the go at the moment?
Quite busy at the moment. Just a little one-off TV shows we're working on, a fashion label, and my shop.
So, yeah. Tell us a little bit more about all of that.
Yeah, just, well, obviously my shop is that I run it in as a family business, so that's keeping me really busy. I can't say too much about the label we're designing and also the TV show, so, but yeah, it's keeping me busy.
Looking to the future, do you think you're going to be focusing more on the TV or the fashion?
I have a passion for both, so hopefully both still.
In terms of fashion, who are your fashion icons? Who are your fashion inspirations?
Loads of fashion icons. I love fashion designers, not who wears them, who designs the clothing. And I find that's more important. So,
are there any names in particular, any designers?
Well, I'm wearing a brand called Nico de Donna today, who I use quite a lot and wear quite a lot, and we work together all the time. So, yeah, I love it.
Have you been catching any of London Fashion Week, obviously, been going on?
I have catched literal tiny, tiny, tiny bits of it, like just watched on the TV, like on the adverts and stuff. That's about it. But I'd love to go. Maybe I might go next year.
You should be. I think you should be. You could be there with your new brand.
I should be with my brand. I should. Whoever knows, who will know.
Final question. Have you got a message to all your fans? Anything you'd like to say to all of them watching?
Of course I have. I love them all. And thanks for watching.
Guys, it's fantastic to have you here tonight. Are you looking forward to the film?
Tremendously. I mean, any film about a mother and a son on a long road trip has got to be brilliant. I think it's one of the most interesting relationships there is.
Why do you think it's such a fascinating dynamic there?
Because I've got two daughters, and never having had a son, I've always wondered what it would be like. And I imagine it would be the premier love affair of your entire life, but you'd have to kind of pretend it wasn't. So I just think it's going to be good. I'm very intrigued by it.
Talking about your mum, what's the most embarrassing or most demanding thing she's ever done? Has she ever made you go on any lengthy road trips?
We don't generally go on road trips, but she does like to collect friends for me. And she once made a friend for me while she was out for dinner, and then I had to go to his birthday party the next day. But we're still very good friends, and it was actually a great find. So
it worked out well.
It worked out well, but at the time...
I don't know what you're complaining about. You got a good friend.
At the time, it was quite an awkward moment because I had to arrive at somebody's party who I did not know and be like, my mother has sent me.
What's
so it was all
that?
A bit...
And your point is what?
It was great. I don't...
Sometimes you know. Mother knows best.
I'm really looking forward to the film. I love Barbara Streisand anyway. I think she's absolutely fantastic. One of my heroes, actually. So I'm really looking forward to the film, yeah.
Why do you love Barbara so much? Why is she here?
Well, she's like, I remember growing up with her. You know, I remember crying to like films she was in and listening to her voice. And I just absolutely love her. I mean, she's part of my era, really. I mean, I don't know how old she is. How old is she?
I think she's getting younger, to be honest. I can't keep track.
She's got to be nearly 60, hasn't she? She is. So I'm 50, nearly 52. So, yeah, so I relate to her. I think she's fantastic.
Obviously, this is a film about a slightly excruciating road trip, mother-son. What's the worst thing you've ever made your kids do with you?
Do you want to answer that, Fred?
No, go on.
I think I'm just a really embarrassing mum. Like, all of my kids get... I embarrass them, but I think actually that's what mums are meant to do, aren't they? Embarrass their kids. Kicked him out of the car. That's the worst thing I've ever done, so, yeah.
Why did you kick him out of the car?
I can't remember. Why did I kick you out of the car?
Because
I gave him a fiver as we got in the car, and as we got in the car, he'd lost it, so I kicked him out of the car, so I can't really remember that, but I did.
Fair enough. You lose. What are you up to yourself at the moment? What's coming up next?
Well, today I've actually been in Bella Sorella all day. Lydia's actually... Well, we started filming Monday, so Tao is back on Sunday. There was a lot of them on ITV today at 12 o'clock promoting it. So Tao is back, so that means we're back manic as ever. And Lydia's having a break from Tao at the moment, so she's really, really... wrapped up in her fashion range at the moment. So she was doing a photo shoot all day today. today. That's where she is still now. I think she's doing a 10-hour photo shoot today with her sister. So I've been working in the shop all day today. And it's half term week, so I've been bug hunting. I've done lots of things this week. My life's always pretty manic, really, to tell you the truth. Don't really get much time. So that's why I really did grab this chance, because it's really nice just to have a bit of mum and Freddie time. He's not interested. He doesn't really want to be here, but, you know, I've got Freddie with me.
Obviously, I think fans are really excited for the show to be back. What can they expect?
I think they've got to expect really big things this time. There's been a big mix-up. We've got a great big new team with this. I think there's about two people from the original team still left. So there's been a big shake-up, lots of new blood, lots of new ideas. I think it's going to be fantastic. I'm really excited, really excited. Really sad on one hand because my Lydia's not in it, and that isn't to say she's never going to be in it. She just is having a break at the moment, so hopefully she will come back into the show. But I'm excited because I think it's going to be really funny, this series. There's lots of things going on, especially with me, Nanny Pat and Carol, and we're like the three witches of Eastwick, us three. So there's lots of funny things in store.
You mentioned new blood. Are there any particular new faces you think we're going to enjoy?
No, I don't mean as in new cast, because I don't know of any new cast. It's the same lot. I mean as in new, there's new directors, new storyliners, new producers, new editors. There's like a whole new team of people been sort of brought in from all different angles. So there's different, when you get that, you've got different angles of things. You know, even yourself when you're filming, if you film with someone different, there's different ways of doing things. So, but it's the same old lot. It's the same Towie lot. There's only one Towie lot, I'm afraid.
Final question before we let you go and talk to your son tonight. Do you have a message to Towie fans out there? Anything you'd like to say to all of them?
Keep watching. And I hope that you really enjoy series 8 and 9 and 10 and 216.